Yo, it's your boy Felipe.
Mickey Solo, P.I.F. Paid in full, yeah.
Yeah, stay hooked onto Nuve Life.
Hi, what's up, people? This is Andrew the Bull, Your Highness, and you're listening to Nuve Life.
Yo, 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 you're now listening to Hip Hop Uganda Live. Your boy truly, Sean. Home for Ugandan Hip Hop. Hosted by yours truly, Sean.
Hey, yo, what's up? It's your boy Anonymous. G2 Complex, most official. And you're listening to Hip Hop Uganda on Nuve Life.
Just right
not
here,
just right here.
Get
right
it, get it.
You're now listening to another episode of the Nuve Life podcast, Hip Hop Uganda Live, hosted by Sean.
Welcome to the Nuve Life podcast, Hip Hop Uganda Live, and I'm Sean, your host. This is episode 7. Last week I had the most unapologetic episode, and I was hitting on the hip-hop ignorant and weed smoking rappers. Anyway, that is left in the past. It's a brand new day and it's a brand new week and a show. I have a surprise for you, and on the show today I have Race T and Rodney. What's up, guys?
I'm cool.
Yeah,
Rodney.
What's up?
Yeah, you might be knowing Race T from the Pretty Girls single and Rodney from the
TBT.
Yeah. Throwback, in other words. So, Race T, what's up?
Yeah, hi guys. My name is Race T. My full names are Mbabazi Race T. I'm a Christian rapper from Uganda. I love the Lord. My name Race T stands for Resting for the Truth. Something about me is can't escape demons from stay
scheming, turn to a fake friend. You're now listening to another episode of the Nuve Life podcast, Hip Hop Uganda Live, hosted by Sean.
Okay, I've always dreamt of performing on stage. I've always dreamt of being on stage, but I tried singing. That was in my form 1, form 2, form 3, form 4. I tried singing, but I wasn't perfect. But I always dreamt being that star on the stage. So I got inspired by a rapper called Jimo. Jimo is he was in Coca-Cola Rated Next, and he was among those contestants. He was among the top 10. That guy is the one who inspired me because he was really a good rapper. He kept pushing me to rap. He wrote for me a few bars and was like, you know what, Resty, I want you to rap. So I started rapping. He would write for me a few things. So I got into the rap game, and it was so amazing because I used to get a lot of awards. I would go for the teens awards and win and compete and win all the time. So that kept me going. The crowd, the noise they would make for me. So it's amazing. But then I've done songs like, I've been featured on songs like I'm a Christian with Bana, Ryonga, Otim, and Solo. Then I've also done my own songs like I'm Free featuring Shali. Then I have Revive Me featuring Anes Trash. Pretty Girls, I had Lady Bizzo on it, I had Zabuli, I had MC Loy, and right now I'm working on a new project called Anea Singer. You'll be hearing me do flows in Luganda, Lutoro, and English, so it's going to be amazing. Yeah, that's all about me.
We can get back to that later on. Rodney, can you tell us your story?
Rodney with the three though. I'm a gospel rapper. I started writing music when I was in my S1. I'd write music but I didn't want to produce it by then. I was waiting for the right time to do it. But I'm more of a songwriter. I do music from the heart. I do gospel music. And what inspired me to enter the industry was my story, my background story. I grew up from a family of three, and we are three kids and one single mother. So I was inspired to do that, to do hip hop because of that story. So yeah, practically that.
I was waiting for that part where you tell me your mom was a singer.
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. Talking about that, yeah, my dad was a singer. My dad is a musician. He does traditional music. So I cooped up and I studied to hip hop. So I'm sorry for that too.
Hey, cool. So, Race-T, you said you had Lady Bees, right?
Yeah.
How was it for you getting in touch with her? Because I know her, she's one of the, I would say, legendary gospel rappers that are out there, and everyone knows her as long as they're tuned into hip hop. So how was it getting to her and putting MC Low is a bully and
I personally used to hear about Lady Bizzo, and I was like, oh my god, how does she look like and all that. So I got to meet her when I was premiering my song Revive Me on Spirit FM on the drive show. So I met her and she was this, you know, down to earth babe. So I was like, you know what, Bizzo, hi, how are you? I want you to be on my song Pretty Girls. And she was like, what? I've not done rap for a long time. How will I manage and all that? So it was kind of through that process that I got to meet her and ask her. And she was okay, by the way. She was okay with it. And yeah, we did the Pretty Girls.
And you all killed it.
Yeah.
Sure thing. So TBT, Pretty Girls are the, like, the household trucks right now.
Yeah, yeah.
And how do you make it turning up in Christ? I remember that was the title of the article. How do you make it?
Turning up in Christ. Many people think, you know, Christian music is boring, and, you know, Christians are boring. They're not supposed to do certain things. They're not supposed to turn up. They're not supposed to drop on turn up beats. They're not supposed to, you know. No. Saying about it's, clubbing.
It's club different from that. You can...
Like, for example, in the time we'll be in club, we'll be launching our mixtape. But you can go to club for a good reason, you know. Yeah, not for club, for the usual reason. So, turning up in Christ, TBT is all about not leaning on the pastor, not letting the pastor take over your life. So TBT is a throwback thing. It's supposed to be Throwback Thursday, but in my own way, I interpreted it as throwback thing.
I'm going to ask you to try to quote for me.
To quote for
your favorite lines on TBT.
Lines, okay,
that
okay.
Are not in English.
Yeah.
You happen to rap in, is that Lunyankole?
Lunyankole. I'm from Barara. I do Lunyankole on every project I drop.
Okay. Yeah. So it's about...
It's like tell them lie to them that you're the one who brought yourself up. So in this verse, I was trying to tell people that it's not about you. It's not about you, your brand, your maybe your family background, your anything. It's about the Lord. It's about the Lord lifting you up and bringing you from the grass to where you are. So I was like, TBT, you don't lean on your own understanding. You don't lean on your own strength, but you lean on the Lord's strength. Yeah.
Let me sound a little bit hard on it.
Okay.
There is one guy who says you need to know your past to know your future,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So was your story saying that you don't have to really mind about the past, but you have to acknowledge it?
You have to acknowledge it. But the inspiration for this one actually came from the Bible. I can quote it from 2 Corinthians 5:17. It says, when someone is in Christ, he's a new creation. Behold, all has passed away. Behold, everything has become new. So I was talking about newness in Christ. I was talking about transformation in Christ. You can remember the past. You did everything in the past. But when you have Christ in you, it's a new story. It's a new page opened. Yeah, so that's what I was trying to say.
Amen. Indeed, amen. So this is a question for both of you.
Yeah.
What do you think is your role as rappers like hip hop artists. Yeah. Beside, we are not categorizing it in any way. Mm. What's your role? What do you think is your role as a rapper? And then the next thing you'll answer is, what do you think is your role as a Christian rapper? You know, the two things that, so I don't know.
Yeah, I'll go first. I guess the rap, but music, to generalize music, not talking about hip-hop or rap, music is all about entertaining people, and hip-hop is all about, you know, preaching a message to someone, sending a message. You can, we have punchlines and wordplay. We use wordplay in between, so you can transfer a message to someone, and they can get it through rap, because you're speaking out some things. You're not saying, you're speaking it out. So I guess our role, the role as rappers, not generally Christian rappers, the role is entertaining and passing on word, passing on the message that you want people to hear. You want people to get and be changed. Yeah, that's the role as a rapper.
Rusty, not to leave you in the background.
Okay,
what do you think
role
is
of rappers is to also inspire the young people out there, because as you go on stage and you rap, it's filled with emotion as you're rapping, because rap is emotional, because some people talk about themselves and all that. So basically, me, I think it's inspiring people. That's my role, to inspire.
And as a Christian rapper, because we tend to see so many rappers come up and they might stop at inspiring. But now, if they're Christian rappers, because that is like, I could call it a uniqueness, because majority of people do rap about things of the world, including the B word and other things, which God is in the place I can't quote. So what do you think is the importance of like Christian rappers? How have you managed to contribute to society?
Caribbean society, we do music, and I think every song that we do is inspired by something. It has a message to preach unto the people. It has a message to transfer. So I guess when someone listens to your song and you're really clear about your message, the message is really brought up very in a very good way. Someone can learn from that and actually go by your footsteps or something. Because before doing this music, we are Christians. We remember that, and we pray to that music. We pray that it will have an impact on someone who's going to listen. We pray that it will change someone. And some people have testified of, I might not be that person, because we are still. But some rappers like Lecrae, KB, Triple E, 116, those guys from America, they have really transferred. And we can't say that is only in America. It's coming to Uganda. It has also come in Uganda. We have Ruyonga. We have
that
many
was,
Christian rappers.
I was about to throw a question at you. Okay.
Yeah. So we have the masterminds of hip hop in Uganda. So people can actually learn from their message and change, you know, someone moving in the wrong way, they can get their way back, and move in the right way.
Yeah, it's really Rusty. Anything to say?
The role of we, the Christian rappers, for example, me, I like empowering girls. That is, I think that's my calling. That's what I really, really love. And I like, I also like the youth,
okay,
because I like changing their lives. Every time I get on stage and perform, I have a word of encouragement to them. So our role as Christians is not just to perform or inspire, is to go ahead and change and get to know people. Me, most of the time when I go to stage, I make sure I get to know these kids, I get to associate with them, I get to tell them something to change their lives, not only performing and all that. So that is my role. That's what I do.
Okay, that's great. You, speaking of empowering girls, how has it been for you? Like, any challenges as a FEMC, a female rapper? Because in the country, I think we do have, if I may not sound biased, but we do have like 7 FEMCs who are quite serious.
Yeah.
Okay, it has been very hard for me that I'm a girl and I'm not bad looking. So I'm very beautiful, by the way. So I get so many people who come to me, and you know, it's hard, and you have to try to work out and make sure these guys don't go to the other direction. I think you get it.
Okay.
Another challenge I get is, you know, we ladies, okay, some people say we are strong, but we are emotionally very weak. So most
frail.
Of it, so most of the time when you go and you do a song and people tell you, you know what, you didn't sound good, it can be like really heartbreaking, and if you're not strong enough, you can't continue. But I've always been strong. I've faced those challenges where people tell me you're not good, you're not making it, but I've kept proving them wrong. I've kept working hard and pushing hard because Rodney has walked that journey with me. He has been there to help me out, to mentor me, and I'm here because of him. He has been helping me. So those are the challenges I've faced. And another thing about girl empowerment I could talk about is I've been paying for myself at campus.
Oh.
As I study and do music, and right now I'm doing accounting and finance. So all those, compiling all those things, music, campus, and
your other side jobs.
Yeah, and getting work to do. So it hasn't been easy. So that's why I use my story to inspire girls who are out there who don't study that you can do it.
I think about 2 weeks ago an episode about side jobs, and I didn't really know who is very good at speaking about side jobs. So how do you manage this? Do you entirely depend on rap music? Because there is one silly, in quotes, tabloid that labeled hip-hop being broke and stuff like that. So do you really profit off rap, or you have your side jobs that you put into the music?
Music, because generally music, to me right now, music provides my upkeep, my hair, my what. But I used to work. Okay, I usually work like holiday times.
Okay.
Because I can't manage school and studying. But I work, and the place where I work, I get a lot of money. Like, okay, that's short time. I won't tell you all those things.
Anyone listening to this, I'm going to leave you with her number.
I get good money. I work like for 3 months and I save a lot of money, and I'm sure that will cater for my tuition and all that. Then I also use, I love fashion, I love clothes, I love dressing up. So usually what I do, I buy clothes and I sell to my friends, like in my room. I do it in my room because I love dressing up, I love all those things. So you find that when time ends, like a period of, I don't know, I have a lot of money on me because I work. So for me, what it has taught me is, man, you don't, it doesn't matter if you're big or you're what, you have to work because you need money.
Okay, I'm getting inspired here now. I'm actually going to change my mind about certain things I thought about Race-T. Rodney.
Yeah.
Dressed like a baller, man.
Dressed like a baller, yeah. By the way, outside of me, I do industrial art at Chamberwe University. So I'm really into art and fashion and design and what. So that's how I actually profit. Sell something, sell some art pieces, get money. I write songs, I get money from them. And yeah, I get money obviously from home, you know. So I really don't have that, you know, permanent side income job. Talking about challenges, the challenges we face as Christian rappers, I think the biggest challenge is about perception of people. When you talk about being a Christian rapper in this youthful stage, everyone is talking about this and that. Everyone has their own way of doing their thing. So they expect you to be perfect. They expect you to like, you know, walk like an angel in that stuff, but it actually helps us. It actually grooms us, and you know which place you're supposed to be in at what time, at which friends you're supposed to relate with, how you're supposed to relate with everyone, despite of their, you know, character and everything. So another challenge is money as rappers. Obviously we need so much money for recording, for videos, for covers, for everything. So you find a problem with money, and it's not like at home they give you that money, they give you like 2 point something and they'll be like, go and make an album. No, they don't do that. So we face you know, those challenges.
I'm inclined to think that for the ladies it's quite easy. I won't be surprised if the next day Rodney came to me and was like, yo, I do have this song. Yeah. I'm a hustler. Anyway, yeah. that's a joke.
But
you guys need to keep grinding and stuff. Mm. Okay, here's this. Mm. What advice would you give to a young rapper like you? I think all of you are below 25.
Yeah, I'm 19.
Mm, Race-T, we're waiting for you.
Me? Yeah, I'm 22.
Okay. In other words, if you know math, divide by 2 and multiply again by 2, subtract by 2, again. She's 20. What advice would you have for a young rapper who's probably under 25?
Yeah.
So maybe even above 25, but they do not know what they're doing. That's if their first lines rotate around money, cars, and falls.
Yeah.
You can replace it with an H.
I think the main thing with rap is all about how your lyrical maturity, you grow. The first song, the second song, you always find a difference in that. So I think it's all about writing. So what I would advise to a young kid, obviously they are still in school probably, like right now.
Yeah.
So I just advise them to keep on writing and to keep on inspiring themselves, to keep on listening to more and more music, to keep on getting
positive
ways of
music?
Yeah, positive music. As a Christian, I'm talking in this sense of a rapper. Now I don't care about
all you're trying to say. They should be exposed.
They should be exposed to more music. Yeah, because what they are doing is actually people expect so much from them. If you're doing international, if you're doing English rap, if you're doing English hip hop, people expect your maturity in your lyrics, your accent, your what. They should work on those things. Writing, delivering lyrics to people, and the message should be clear. So that's what I would advise, and I would advise them to not only look at music as a way of survival. I would advise them to go and be serious about school, be serious about working, be serious about relationships with other people, their friends, their parents, their teachers, everyone. So, yeah.
Race-T, what advice would you have for any youngin out there?
The advice I would give them is love what you do. And always know that you're good. If you expect people to tell you that you're good, trust me, you won't get it. You'll take like a long time to hear that, to hear someone telling you that you're good. So as a young person who is doing music now, me, what I did was, I liked what I did and I pushed hard. And always take yourself as an artist. These things of coming, you want people to push your songs, always push yourself. Do your music the way it's supposed to be done. When you do a song, do artwork. Make sure you're serious about your career and work hard. Make sure you perfect your talent. Because if you don't, you're not going to get anywhere. You need to come when you're perfect. And always learn from other people. Always listen to what people tell you. Have someone to mentor you, to guide you on your direction. And you'll make it. Yeah.
The way she's sounding lovely like that is the way she is dressed today. Okay, she's like the second film she was being on the show from Aggie and then the Sphinx. So, I mean, I have to commend that. Rodney, and it's a general question. I want to each of you to tell me their favorite, I think, artists, rappers,
okay.
And then the inspiration.
Okay.
The ones that inspired you, probably.
Yeah. Basically, talking about, Uganda, so I have to first hit on this market. So the rappers, are like, I'm a big fan of Rihanna. I'm not only under his label, but I'm a very big fan of Rihanna. I like his work. I like his, a very big fan, by the way. Then going back, crossing back, I like American rappers, the first one. I like Lecrae, I like KB, I like Triple E, I like NF, I like... Man, I like many artists, and not only hip hop. I also like R&B, other genres, Afro pop, Afro everything. Yeah, so not only that I get inspiration from gospel hip hop artists, but the inspiration I get is that they have the message. They have a message of delivering things, and they can impact change on this generation. So that's why they inspire me. But before I started writing Christian rap, It was T.I. by then. Yeah, I like T.I. so
the
much.
Troubled one. Are you troubled like him?
I mean, not really, but I really,
do you think the T is for?
T, in T.I. Something like...
What do you think it's for?
I really don't know.
It's troubled, probably. Anyway, it's all good, right? See?
Yeah.
Your Ugandan artists, my best one is obviously Ryonga. He's good. I also like Straight Eloquent. I don't know if you know him, but he's really good.
Straight Eloquent?
Yeah.
You should visit Nuve Live. You can email me your music.
Trust me, that guy is good.
You came with his music today?
I don't really have it, but he's good.
You need to talk to him when we see what's up.
Yeah. Okay. Then I also like other guys. I like Lacrae. I like Jackie Hill. She's a rapper. Then I also like Saya. She's good. Okay, those are underground guys I always listen to.
Okay.
Yeah, those are the guys I listen to. Though many people tell me to listen to Nikki, to Kim and all that.
No.
But I don't.
You should be,
those guys
you
don't
should, you should
really
be
inspire
listening
me.
To Ugandan rappers like Sensei, who have been there, who paved the way for films.
By the way, also
like
Agi.
Oh, the Royal Highness.
Yeah.
Young as they are, I've remembered something. RIP to New Testament.
Yeah.
We lost a very great artist that I didn't meet personally. Mm-hmm. And I think I saw that on Rodney's TL.
Yeah. The week. Actually, he was under this. He was under Hidden Empire, our youngest movement. And RIP to that guy.
Okay. So both of you have worked with Joe Beach, right?
Yeah.
Definitely.
And he's the one behind TBT.
TBT is the one behind TBT. For a public announcement, I'm releasing a single. It's called Crazy. It's going to be released in I think 3 weeks or a month. It's already done, but we are putting so much work on it, and I'm doing covers. I'm doing everything possible. It's really good. It's the guy behind that, Joe Beach, coming and. Really, it's very good. You should expect so much from it.
Okay. Before Race T comes in, make sure you get yourself a Nuve Live I Dig UG Hip Hop sticker. It's out there. You can check our store and get yourself one at only 1,500. Race T?
Yeah. Joe Beats is some guy I met when Bana was doing a song called I'm a Christian, who was going to have Ryonga on it and other guys. So they're like, Christy, come and try out, come and do a small verse. So I went, when I did my verse, it sounded nice, the production was nice, everything was amazing. So I was like, man, I have to try out this guy. He's really good, he has a good presence, he's very humble, he's very good. So I was like, yeah, I have to try out with him, and he understands what I do. So he did for me I'm Free, he did for me Revive Me, he did for me Pretty Girls. I don't know what else he's going to do, but he's good. All the songs I've done have been playing on radios. He's a nice producer.
And they played in the last episode of Pretty Girl, Nuvele. Goddamn, Pretty Girls on my mind. Anyway, any last words before we close up the show? Probably your social media and stuff.
Yeah, for me, as I told you, I'm Race-T. I have a page, you can like my page, it's called Race-T. Then my personal, okay, my account right now is full, but you can just like my page. Then you can also follow me on Instagram. Then also I use Race-T on Instagram. Then also on Twitter, my Twitter handle is Race-T146. Don't forget.
It's all fine. You can visit the page where you found this podcast, and we shall put all that on the blog itself. Rodney?
Yeah, Rodney. I use Rodney with a 3, RODN3Y. Rodney, you can like it on Facebook. On Instagram, I use the Rodney I Am. On Instagram, on Twitter, the Rodney I Am. Snapchat, the Rodney I Am. No WhatsApp number.
Alright, cool. The rest is at R-A-C-E-T. It's, some people might type R-A-E-S-T-Y. So thanks guys for coming for the show.
Yeah. Last word to all of you who are listening to us. We really love hip hop. We really love Yeah, gospel, hip hop, and we really have a message to preach. I pray that everyone will give us an ear. We listen to. We try to get our music. Just give us a try and get us our music. Not only Race-T and me. Get for younger. Get every guy who try out Christian rap, and I'm sure you like it. Try out Lecrae. Try out American rap. Try out every genre of Christian music, and yeah, I'm sure you like it. Yeah, and to the to all the rappers, you know, hip hop. I don't care which style you rap. I don't care your lyric or what, but keep hip hop moving and be positive in your music. Yeah, that's what Uganda needs at this time.
Right, Rodney seems to be a real preacher. Race-T, any last word before I close up?
Just to tell all my fans that I really love you. Thank you so much for supporting me. Even those who don't know me, I know you'll get to know me, but just keep on supporting music, support gospel music. You know, we are at a point where we want to change things. We want also gospel musicians to also be heard. And I thank this website for featuring us and accepting us to be on this whole thing and doing this interview, because it's amazing of how much he, as in this guy, just comes and allows us to be
and
here.
I'm Sean, your host.
Yeah, how Sean has been so loving to us and just called us to be here. So it's just a message, keep supporting us, please follow us, listen to our music. We have
shout
greater
outs.
Things we're doing.
Shout outs to
mommy,
daddy,
shout outs to mommy, I love you. Okay, this is funny, but shout outs to my first to my producer Jobis Gamit. Shout out to everyone who does my cover art. Shout out to everyone who supports my music, my fans out there, Barara Kids and Kole Kids, and lastly shout out to Innovation. This guy is so interesting. Okay, shout out to him. Thanks for giving us a chance for putting our music out there. We really appreciate that.
For anyone who doesn't know about NuveSHAWN, if this is your first time listening to us, you can visit the about page on NuveSHAWN.wordpress.com. Soon upgrading and launching, details will be available soon. This is our goal. We are aiming at mainly looking at the young rappers out there and putting them up there and documenting hip-hop, spoken word and poetry each and every day. And don't forget, the NuveSHAWN EP is coming through, and I should deliver this to you. It's called The Dolphin Enterprise. So far, one single of it is underway, and I've been Sean, your host. This has been episode 7, the NuveSHAWN podcast, Hip Hop Uganda. You don't forget to follow us on Twitter at NuveSHAWN, Facebook NuveSHAWN, Instagram NuveSHAWN, and personally you can follow me on Twitter at NuveSHAWN. That is NuveySHAWN. Been Sean, your host, out.